Good morning children, today we are going to start matter in our surrounding present. Already we learned some basics about matter. So matter means what? Matter is anything that has mass and value, which is nothing but occupies space. And properties of matter, there are two properties of matter. One is physical properties of matter and another one is chemical properties of matter. And we learned states of matter. There are three states of matter: solid, liquid and gases. These are the basic things already we have learned. Today we are going to start this lesson. What we will study in this lesson? So these are the main concepts you are going to learn in this lesson. First one is physical nature of matter. And the second one is characteristics of particles of matter. And the third one is states of matter. Fourth one is can matter change its state. And the fifth one is evaporation. These are the topics you are going to learn in this lesson. In the first, today we are going to see first topic, physical nature of matter. So in this physical nature of matter, two subtopics are there. One is matter is made up of particles and the second one is size of the particles. So today we are going to see about matter is made up of particles. For a long time, two scientists of thoughts prevailed regarding the nature of matter. So one scientist believed the matter is continuous like wooden block. The other scientist thought matter is made up of minute particles like sand. So let us perform an activity to decide the nature of matter. So for this activity you require take 100 ml beaker. So you have to take 100 ml beaker, and the second point is fill half the beaker with water and mark the level of water. So already I filled half the beaker of water and we are going to mark the level of water. See, I am going to mark the level of water. Okay. First we want to take 100 ml beaker. We have to fill the beaker half with water and we have to mark the level of water. And the third one is dissolve some salt with the help of glass rod. Okay, so we have to dissolve some amount of salt. This is glass rod. Using glass rod, we are going to dissolve the some amount of salt. So I am taking salt and I am mixing in this water. So using glass rod, we have to dissolve the amount of salt. So observe properly, children. So with the help of glass rod, you should keep on stirring. So if you stir, it will disappear. So you have to dissolve continuously. Okay. And what do you think has happened to the salt? So what you are thinking after stirring, what happened to that salt? Where does it disappear? Salt is not visible now. So does the level of water change? Children? No. So what happened to the salt? Here you can see, I draw a diagram here. So this is nothing but beaker. We have filled half level water and then we mixed. This, I mentioned this circle is nothing but water molecule. And this is nothing but salt. So already we know some basics that liquid particles are arranged loosely. So in between the water molecules, there is space between them. So in that space, the salt occupied the space. So first one is water level is constant. There is no change in the water level. And second one is salt spread throughout water. So what happened to the salt? Salt not spread at only one particular place. It spread throughout the water molecule. And the third one is when we dissolve salt in water, the particles of salt get into the spaces between particles of water. So completely it occupies the space. water. I hope you all understood. Matter is made up of particles. If you have any doubt, you can ask children. Thank you.